since you've been doing this.
Oh, at least 3,000 or 4,000. You know, it's interesting, back in around 1970, I had my first case, and it's interesting, there was this couple who was living in a condo, and they were getting electrical phenomenon going on in the middle of the night. They were getting, like, electrical discharges on the ceiling and all kinds of electrical, electrical shocks in their bed. And I said, well, who would want to do this? And they said, well, the people next door are trying to run us out because they want to buy our condo. It could be them. So it was later on, I'm not going to tell you how we managed to figure it out, but later on we found out is that these people next door were running a Tesla generator, a million volt Tesla generator that was contacted on the wall, and they were actually throwing these lightning kind of sparks across the whole structure of the wall that bordered from their place to the victim's place. And I was able to finally get pictures of this machine, and the son was a physics student out at UCLA at the time that put the thing together, and they were just trying to run these people out. And at that time, I named it electronic harassment. I'm the individual that gave it that name, because with using technology like million volt Tesla machines to try to harass your neighbors, to electrify them through the walls, to me was electronic harassment. So that was probably my first case, and that's when I gave it the nomenclature electronic harassment.
Roger, when you add up the drones and everything else that's been going on, along with things that have happened to people like Michael, what picture does that paint for you? What is going on?
Well, what's going on is that we are moving into this 1984 society where we're going to be under constant surveillance. And if you are someone that disagrees with the government line on whatever subject matter it is, they will do several different things. They will send drones to, first of all, spy on you or use the televisions that there's some information that I sent you to look at as well, that they're now discovering that these new televisions have the ability to use cameras and audio functions that they're not supposed to have, but for some reason now they're being manufactured with the ability to bypass those safeties. So now we're going to get in a situation where Big Brother's going to be watching us. It's almost identical to that 1984 scenario. And of course, we did a full show on the 1984 prophecy some years ago.